Behind the Green Bird pub, there was a big car park. It was a busy pub, and every night there were lots of cars there. Tonight, there was a woman in the car park too. She stood in the dark behind a tree, watching and waiting. Her name was Rosa, and she was 20 years old. She worked in a hotel 6 days a week, but not on Mondays. On Mondays, Rosa did something different. And today was Monday. It was cold. Rosa pushed her hands into the pockets of her coat. It was a night for trousers, but Rosa wore a short skirt and nothing on her legs. That was important. After a time, a woman came out of the pub and walked across the car park to a blue Ford car. The woman was about 50 years old, and she walked slowly. She sang quietly, with a little smile on her face. "She's drunk," Rosa thought, "but she's going to drive." The woman got to her car and put a hand on it. She wore a long green coat and grey trousers, and she had blonde hair. Very, very blonde hair.
"Oh dear, my head," she said, then laughed.
"That hair colour came out of a bottle," Rosa thought. She took a small bottle from her pocket. There was some red liquid in it, and she put some of the liquid on her leg. Then she ran quickly round the car park to the blue Ford. The woman opened the car door and half fell into the driving seat. She laughed.
"Oh, Dorothy Burns," she sang. "You're drunk again."
Rosa was now behind her car, crouching on the ground. When the car began to move back, she jumped to her feet and hit the car with her hand. Bang! The car stopped suddenly, and Rosa fell down on the ground behind the car. She put her hand on the red liquid on her leg and quickly put some of it on the back of the car. Dorothy Burns got out of her car and walked round to the back. When she saw Rosa on the ground, her face went white.
"Oh," she cried. What happened?"
"My leg," Rosa said. "Oh, my leg."
She began to cry.
But what happened?"
said Dorothy Burns. Then she saw the red liquid on Rosa's leg.
"Oh, there's blood on your leg."
"Yes, because your car hit me, that's why,"
Rosa said. She stopped crying and began to look angry.
I didn't see you behind me,"
Dorothy Burns said.
"You didn't see me because you didn't look,"
Rosa said angrily. She stared at the woman.
"You're drunk."
Dorothy Burns was suddenly very afraid.
I...
"Yes, you smell of whiskey. I can smell it from here," Rosa said. "I'm going to call the police now."
"Oh no, please," Dorothy Burns said. "I'm very, very sorry, but not the police, please."
"Listen, I can help you. I can drive you home and..."
"I'm not getting in that car with you," Rosa said.
"You're drunk."
"No,"
Dorothy Burns said.
Just one small whiskey, that's all.
Oh, yes. Tell that to the police.
Rosa stood up, holding her leg.
What's the number of your car?
No, please, Dorothy Burns said. Not the police. Listen, I want to help you. Take a taxi to the hospital. I can give you the money for it. Go to the accident.
How much money? Said Rosa.
£20?
Dorothy Burns said.
50,
Rosa said.
Well, how about 30?
Said Dorothy Burns.
50. But I haven't got a lot of money with me. 50. I'm calling the police now.
Rosa took a mobile phone out of her coat pocket.
Okay, okay, said Dorothy Burns.
She got her handbag from the car, took out £50, and gave the money to Rosa.
Here you are,
she said. Rosa took the money and walked away. She went down the street to her car, a small white Fiat, 10 years old. She sat in the car and waited for the woman to drive away. Then Rosa drove home. On the next 3 Monday evenings, Rosa went to 3 different pubs. She waited for a drunk or nearly drunk driver to come out. Sometimes she waited 2 hours or more. Then she took out her little bottle of red liquid. And minutes later, there was an accident. The drivers never wanted Rosa to call the police. They were always ready to give her money. Sometimes it was £50, sometimes 100. Once, a big fat man with gold teeth gave her £200. That was a very good Monday. The next Monday, Rosa found a pub in a street not far from the Green Bird. It was a very cold night, so she waited in her car. After an hour, a man came out of the pub with a bottle of wine in one hand. He stood looking up and down the car park. Rosa watched him.
He can't find his car, she thought. He's drunk.
After a minute or two, the man began to walk across the car park to a big red Honda. Twice his foot slipped and he nearly fell. But at last he got to the Honda and began to open the door. Rosa put some red liquid on her leg and got out of her car. She walked quickly to the Honda and crouched down at the back of it, ready for the accident.
Hey, you!
Rosa quickly looked round. A woman ran across the car park. A woman in a green coat and grey trousers. A woman with very blonde hair. She had a camera in her hand. Rosa stood up and began to walk away. But Dorothy Burns was quicker than she was.
Oh, no, you don't, Dorothy shouted.
She grabbed Rosa's arm.
You were at the Green Bird 4 weeks ago.
What? Who are you? What are you talking about? Said Rosa. I'm just going home. Let go of my arm.
The man with a wine bottle in his hand came round to the back of his Honda.
Hey, what are we doing? What's happening?
He said. His face was very red, and his eyes were half closed. This woman took £50 from me 4 weeks ago, Dorothy Burns told him. She's a fake. She gets down behind your car, and then says your car hit her.